ஐ மை செல்ஃப் டாக்டர் கே செல்வராஜ் எம்ஃபாம் பிஹெச்டி அசோசியேட் ப்ரொஃபஸர் கேஎம்சிஹெச் காலேஜ் ஆஃப் ஃபார்மசி கோயம்புத்தூர் தமிழ்நாடு வி வில் கண்டினியூ தி சப்போசிட்டரிஸ் இன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வீடியோ வி கிவ் த டெஃபினேஷன் ஃபார் சப்போசிட்டரிஸ் எஸ் எனி ஒன் சே வாட் ஆர் சப்போசிட்டரிஸ் சப்போசிட்டரிஸ் ஆர் எஸ் மெடிக்கேட்டர் சாலிட்ஸ் தே ஆர் இன்ட்ரடியூஸ்ட் இன் டு த பாடி கேவிட்டிஸ் லைக் ரெக்டம் வெஜினல் ஆர் யூரித்ரல்ஸ் Now we move to what are the various methods by which we can prepare suppositories. The methods by which we can prepare suppositories are, the first one is the suppository mold method, cold compression method and hand rolling technique. So these are the two, three methods by which we can prepare the suppositories. The first one interesting method is the suppository mold method. In this method, suppository mold in commercial, it is available at a different strength, that is commercial in various shapes having available, that is 6 to 500 cavities are available. 6 to 500 cavities are available. It is usually made up of metals like stainless steels, aluminium, nickel, copper alloys and then brasses used for making suppository molds. The steps involved in the preparation of the suppositories are, the first step is, first we move to the lubrication of the mold. Why we want to make a lubrication of the mold? Yes, you are right. Lubrication is done to avoid the adherence of these suppository bases to the mold. So the mold should be lubricated. What are the various substances used to lubricate the mold? Yes, you are right. It is liquid paraffin or glycerin or commonly used to lubricants. The suppository bases, now we move to these methodology. The suppository bases are melted. What are the suppository bases? Yes, you are right. It's that is cocoa butter, athiobromo oil, glycerogelatin bases, PEG, and then emulsifying bases like mass astronom. These are the various bases. They can melt with the drug either dispersed or dissolved in it. Now it is called as melted mass. Okay, now it is called as melted mass. This mass is then poured into the suppository cavity, molding cavities, and allowed to conceal at cold temperature. It's clear? Yes, you are right. Then the suppositories are removed from the mold and evaluated. So this is the method by which we can prepare the suppository mold technique. Now the second one is what we call as the cold compression technique. In this method, the suppository bases and the drug molecule both are mixed and they are forced through a compression mold. See here the instrument, I am showing this instrument. What is the name of the instrument for the using this cold compression technique? Okay, now in this method the mass is forced to extrude the by means of a piston on hand power operating compression machines. Okay, now in this method the lead does not require any heat, so that this is best suitable for the thermolabile substances or drugs molecules, but it is unsuitable for glycerogelatin suppositories where little value of the melting is essential for the preparation of the masses. So the suppositories are prepared by the above mentioned three methods. Now we move to some definition. What is meant by displacement value and its calculation? The displacement value, the quantity of the medicament that displaces one part of the base, is called as a displacement value. What is the necessity of the displacement value? See, to get a uniformity of the weight, here the density is considered here. So the density is due to the variation in the density of the medicament and the basis is calculated. So the displacement value is very, very essential in the preparation of the suppositories. We am giving some values for the displacement values for the some medicaments. So that is aminophylline 1.5 and the chloral hydrate is 1, phenobarbital is 1 and the cocaine hydrochloride is 1.5 and the tannic acid is 1, zinc oxide is 5, iodoform is 3.6 and aspirin is 1.1 and metronidazole is 1.7 and paracetamol is 1.5. So displacement value is very, very important for your exam point of view. Now everything is over. Now we move to this evaluation of the suppositories. Evaluation of the suppositories. What are the various evaluation parameters we can use to evaluate these suppositories? This one is the organoleptic examination. Second one is the uniformity of the weight. Third one is the melting range test. Melting range test. Fourth one is the liquefaction or softening of times. And the fifth one is this penetration test. And sixth one is this mechanical strength and dissolution and disintegration test is the seventh one. These are the various evaluation parameters for the supposed trees. First one is this uniformity of the weight. What is the necessity of uniformity weight? All the supposed trees should be uniform in weight. The weight variation may result if some cavities are unfilled, sometimes are overfilled. So the 20 supposed trees are taken. The average weight is taken for that one and individual weight is taken. So no supposed tree should deviate from the average weight by more than 5%, and except that two should deviate from more than 7.5%, that is the IFE specification. Now we move to this melting range test, otherwise called as macro melting test. Here we are measuring the time taken for entire supposed tree to melt. What is that? They measure the time taken for the entire supposed tree to melt when it is immersed in a constant water bath. The constant water bath is maintained 37 degrees Celsius, as like our body temperature. So this is what we call as a melting range test, that is macro melting test. Measure the time taken for the entire supposed tree to be melted, that is immersed in a constant temperature 37 degrees Celsius in a water bath. Next one is this, third one is the liquefaction or softening time. This is the time performed on rectal supposed trees to determine the softening time of the supposed trees. Okay, what is the method by which we can perform this? During this test, a glass rod is placed in the supposed tree held in a U-tube. U-tube is U-tube of this apparatus immersed in a constant temperature. We are placing a glass rod. So the time taken the rod to pass through, it's clear, the time taken for the rod to pass through the supposed tree is recorded, is called as a supposed tree timing. Then breaking or the mechanical or crushing strength. Then the test is used to determine the kilogram weight to supposed tree can withstand by breaking. So these are the various tests we can perform to evaluation. Thank you very much. Have a good day. Have a good day.